I'm up early today. My goal is to photograph one of the rarest birds in the Netherlands, the Black Grouse. There are only a few areas where there are a few individuals left. One of those areas is not so far from my home. Although I have photographed this bird before, I haven't yet made a photo that I'm really happy with. Most of the times when these birds can be seen is when they are up in the tree. And that's immediately also the problem. Because that means that often the photo will have a bright white sky behind the bird. But more about that later. First I have to cycle up this hill. Already happy I got out. Oh, amazing. Just imagine this light, the background, and then a black grouse on top of one of those trees. That was the goal. But it's really, really quiet. I hear some mountain bikers further away in the distance. I hope they will not come this way. Really nice. I'm just going to sit here for a while and have a good look around to see if I can see any birds or a roe deer that I can photograph. So the reason why I'm here is because this hill gives me a really nice opportunity to get a really nice background. Often what you get with a bird that sits a lot up in the trees, like with a black grouse, you will be photographing against the sky. And often a sky is very bright and then the bird is dark. Yeah, by nature, especially the males of the black grouse are really dark. I have to admit, right now, there's no black grouse. So I can't make that photo I am hoping to make. But that's the thing with photography. You need to stick to it, come back, and eventually you will get that photo that you're looking for. I hang around for a while, but as the good light was slowly disappearing, I decided to move. Having a little bite like this one with me helps me a lot. I can cover a larger distance than by foot alone. I kept going from one hilltop to the other, each time scouting the treetops to see if there was any black grouse around. But after several hours, I still had no luck. I was already beginning to accept that it would not happen this day. So I was just standing here, checking out the tops of the trees to see if I could see a black grouse. And then a female, just from behind here, she flew up and over me and then over there into the heather. Oh. That's always how it goes.
especially those females, they are so hard to see. They have the perfect camouflage. So you're really close and they just sit still and you just don't see them until they think, I this is too close. And then they fly off and then you catch one. But it goes so quickly, it's no use to get the camera and try to make a photo. The thing is, they fly away, so even if you make a photo, it will be the backside. Amazing was that? So I went looking over here after that female, but then I saw a male sitting up in the tree, but it was against the sky background, so that was not really what I was hoping for, right? So I was trying to find a place that I could get at least the forest, at the edge of the forest over there in the background, and then suddenly there were two males up in the tree, and I got around a few times looking for a better angle and maybe to see if I could get that house in the background, and then there was suddenly a female with it. So they were up at three up, so there were two males and a female up in that tree, which was really awesome. But not with the background that I want, right? So I kept looking. But then they flew back down. I was, no, so we were trying to find them back. They were flying all the way down into the valley. Maybe you guys can see it all the way down. So I stuck around and then a couple flew back up, practically over my head. I could see them coming. But the light is pretty terrible today, so I had my camera on 1/500th of a second. I had no idea if the photo worked out. Sometimes a photo which is moved also looks nice, right? Can also really look nice. Oh. So they got back up and there was one male who really... he sat up in the tree. And then at that moment, the sun peeked through the clouds as well. With some nice side lighting. Oh, I hope that photo worked out. So that's the situation right now. They are around, they are feeding. You just need to be... So, they went back down, right? And then they went back up again. And then I saw a couple flying around there. So maybe they all moved. So I'm just going to cycle into that direction. And with some luck, if I get the other path back down, that's the path that I originally came up. That path has a lot of amazing opportunities to get that background really, really awesome day, but not yet the photo that I'm looking for. Again, in the background, I see two male. Let's see if I can make a few photos.
Remember that female? That photo turned out okay. Although I did have to use the motion blur option from Topaz Sharpen. You can clearly see the transmitter that the scientists used to locate the birds. The female joined the two males up in the tree. But this photo really shows the problem with a dark bird against a bright white sky. It needs a lot of editing to bring up some detail in the birds. But even if I would do so, it would really look unnatural. I kept moving around, so I could include the edge of the forest as a background. And although this background is a lot more interesting than a bright white sky, I'm still not happy with the bright spots and the white upper part of the photo. Over the next hours I kept following the birds. Eventually a whole group ended up in a birch tree. The scene was amazing. I was able to simplify the background after moving around a bit. But the birds were really far away and there was a lot of moisture in the air. So I did not really like the photo. I added a more artistic effect using the bleach filter from the Nick collection. And although this will not be a portfolio piece, it remains very special to have a significant amount of the Dutch population up in one tree. In an ideal situation I would set up a hide, but that's not possible here. There are very strict rules here and I can only photograph them from the paths. Eventually one of the males set up high in a pine tree. And although I do like the background, it was really far away, adding a lot of haze in the photo. So I sort of got the photo that I want, but not yet the photo. But that's okay. That just gives me reason to return here, and that's never a bad thing. I hope you enjoyed this vlog. If you did, a like and a comment would be much appreciated. If you aren't subscribed already, please do so and do not forget to hit that notification bell. And then we will see each other again in my next vlog.